we continue tonight on Hannity, we continue with the great one, Mark Levin, author of the brand new book, Rediscovering Americanism and the Tyranny of Progressivism. You know, Mark, I was listening to you in the last segment, and you're talking about the need for the intellectual foundation, founders, framers, Constitution, and even beyond that, those that inspired these guys. You know, I look at President Trump, and here's a guy that, you know, frankly, practical, common sense, instinctive knowledge that big government is oppressive and wrong, regulations are burdensome, it's hurting the American people, millions more in poverty on food stamps and out of the labor force, doubling our debt is dumb, you know, top-down healthcare is stupid. And he has all of that instinctively. And look at how those forces that support the opposite of what you're explaining in this book react to him trying to drain that swamp and get back to those founding principles, perhaps without the intellectual foundation that maybe you have, but frankly, you're one of a few people that really do.
They're definitely out to destroy him, and I think they're out to destroy him for three fundamental reasons. Number one, he's not one of them. And they really thought they'd get Hillary Clinton in four more years of this crazy leftist-type government. That's number one. Number two, he's striking them where they believe they have absolute monopoly control in the administrative state. The departments and agencies, we have this massive fourth branch of government that is nowhere in the Constitution.
The deep state.
That passes deep state, but it passes 3,000 to 4,000 laws a year without our input. It continues to operate despite the public will. It rejects electoral outcomes. That is the progressive leftist power base, the administrative state. And number three, the courts. The unelected judges and justices in this country, and you saw what a disaster they were in these district court cases, and thank goodness we have a Supreme Court that took a look at his executive order on immigration, and it was a 95% victory there for
Let
the president,
this,
and congratulations
Mark.
To him. Yep.
If you're talking to the president and you said, how do you defeat these forces that are selectively leaking, the corruption that is against him, what specific advice do you give him based on your research here?
Well, first of all, he can't defeat them. He can start the process of defeating them. And this is one of the things that bothers me. President Reagan was in there 8 years, started the process. And then the other Republican presidents come in and they unravel it. It's like with Obamacare right now. The Republicans are basically giving their imprimatur to a massive progressive government program. The way you do it is this. You shrink the size of government. If you're going to go into every department and agency, it's like hand-to-hand warfare in the jungle. That doesn't work. Slash them across the board except for defense and federal law enforcement and intel. Slash them across the board, 10%, 15%, 20%. Call in McConnell, call in Ryan, and read them the Riot Act if you can. And if they won't do what the president says, then replace them. He's the leader of the Republican Party. Replace them. So far, I would replace them, but what do I know? So you need to do that. There's another issue, too.
I'm with you, Mark. I'm sick and tired of them. They have no urgency, no fight.
Well, here's the problem, Sean. I have Russian heritage, so I go to jail in 2 seconds, you know, so that would rule me out. Even though I can't stand them, that's a whole other issue. But that said, you know, I've been behind another movement called the Article 5 Convention of States, and I wish the president and his administration would take a look at it, even though they don't have a direct role. And that would allow us, through our state legislatures, to change the nature of this government, which has been stolen from us. This is not anymore a representative republic, not with a massive administrative state, or a federal republic with federalism, since the states basically do what they're told.
How many states are on board now?
Yeah. We have 12, and we need 34, but we have 12 without any real effective national push. That's a big deal. And the other thing is, we're not really a constitutional Republican. I don't know what we are, but the reason they're trying to chew up Trump is because Trump is not one of them. He doesn't belong to their club. And I'm going to say something else that's not even related to this. I want to thank the president for something. He gets attacked for this. Thank you for taking on the media. It's a damn about time somebody did. Don't stop tweeting. Be more careful with your tweets, but don't stop tweeting because you're able to go over the head of the media.
Absolutely.
The way Reagan did with his speeches. You can be more careful. I don't care. Are the media careful about what they report? No.
No.
So in any event,
great
I'm one.
One
of those, count me in the minority that says, keep at it, keep at it, keep at it.
Mark, always good to see you, my friend. That's why we call you the great one. Thank you. And coming up, another big win today for the president, his administration, Supreme Court reinstating, yes, the president's temporary travel ban. They will also hear oral arguments about the issue in the fall. Jay Sekulow weighs in next. And later tonight, this is important, one of the major purveyors of fake news, conspiracy news in this country, over the weekend forced to eat crow after it published a story about a Trump associate in Russia. Guess what? Wasn't true, like so many others. A very important mini monologue straight ahead.